Greetings and salutations, I'm Keb. Welcome back to this Let's Play of European Universalis 4 as the Polish-Lithuanian Commonwealth, and I've been doing some mathematics in the breaks. Yeah, had to bring out pen and paper and stuff. At any rate, it seems like these armies at the moment costs me a total of 7.86 ducats to maintain. Of course, that's provided all these numbers stay stable. I'm kind of surprised though, because it looks like the maintenance cost actually changes during the game. I didn't realize that, because at the start of the game, I don't mean the modifiers, but the actual base price, because in the early game, the artillery costs a fortune. Far more so than cavalry. But now the base cost seems to be equal. Which kind of confuses me. But there we have it. Or am I looking at the wrong bracket here? Regiment costs. Base cost 25. Yeah, something here is odd. No, something here is really odd. So the base tooltip, when I hover over for the cohorn mortar. Yeah, something's very wrong here. The tooltip here is the same one for cavalry and artillery. See? Because I don't think Polish traditions reduce the cost of... no regiment costs. Okay. Noble knights. That's... Noble knights give a cavalry cost reduction. Cavalry cost. And artillery is not cavalry. So yeah, the tooltip here is wrong. For whatever reason, when I hover over here, I get the tooltip for the cavalry. So yeah. Okay, so this costs a lot more than it says here. Okay. And since I can't actually check the tooltip, since I can't actually check what the actual cost is. Well, this sucks. Now I can't actually compute the cost of this regiment, because I don't know exactly how much the artillery pieces will cost me. Because I don't know the modifiers for it. Well, the base price is 26 ducats. That's annual upkeep, I believe. No, it's not. That's the base cost of recruitment. Where would I have to go to check the cost of maintenance? Can I check that here? That shows me total army maintenance. So then I need to check. Let's see. 1, 2, 3. Okay, so I have 6 of those. That's 6 times 30 troops in total. I don't need to compute. Oh my goodness, more mathematics. So basically, I can go this the other way around. I could compute the monthly cost of all my infantry and all my cavalry, and deduct that number from the army's cost here. That's the only one, and then I need to split it up based on how many artillery units I have. And that's the only way for me to actually find out how much a single piece of artillery is costing me in maintenance right now. Because the tooltip doesn't work. Grumble. Yeah, so if anyone wants to report this bug, please do. It definitely is a bug. Maybe I should do that myself. I'll make a note. I mean, if a Rumba can make his adjustments, maybe Keb can make some corrections. Tooltip. Artillery cost. Of course, it could be that this is just my game that's broken. I'll have to check that, but definitely looks like there's a bug here. Okay, so at least now I know it's going to cost more than the 7.86 ducats I calculated. Quite a bit more. And the reason I computed that number is because I want that number is to know whether or not my budget here can support one more group of these guys. And the answer looks like yes, just barely. Moving on. We need to adjust the half line then. I want to edit it. I want to edit this army template. How do I do that? If I click on it, I build it. If I right click, I delete it. Okay, another one for adjustments, I guess. Okay, sorry about this. Pardon the delay. Let me see, that's recruitment. Here I might see it. Yeah, there I might see it. Oh, good lord. Thank goodness we can actually see the cost here. Base maintenance, 0.58 per month. So it's pretty much twice the amount of that. Okay, so let me compute that. That's 0.58 times... There we go. Okay, so the maintenance cost should actually be 9.66. Okay, in that case I can afford it, but... pity I can't modify this one. Okay, right click. No, I don't really want to delete it and don't want to build it, I want to edit it. Ugh. And since I can't... Yeah, I have to delete it because I need the same name! Boo. Okay, so add 10, there we go, and then subtract 2. 3 cavalry. 9. 30 provinces. Though, as soon as I've done that, I probably forgot that to check the new combat width. Combat width has increased to 36. So 18 and 18 brings me to 36. Okay. And plus the cavalry. Okay then, we can probably keep going there. When is the combat width increase in the tech tree? Yeah, the next level will increase it by 2. If anything, we could probably use more artillery to get up to the next siege breakpoint, which I believe would require not 12 cannons, maybe more. Nah. Oh, of course, I can't actually afford to build one. Oh, never mind then. All that stuff and nothing to show for it. Bah. All that, nothing to show. Ah, boo. And we are converting provinces. Very good. Keep doing that. I assume he was pissed because of conversion. No? Just because he can be pissed. No salads. That can arise in time, so I don't need you up here. Yeah, I'm gonna bring you down here. The Turk has a lot of troops, so I'm not sure I want to mess with him until I'm good and ready. Okay, 22, it's gonna take us how much to get another one? 40, okay, and that'll take me how long? At least another year, probably more. And in that year, he might well tech up again. Ah, blasted ratings. Yeah, I kind of... The only reason that I'm not putting a huge navy here and dealing with all that crap is... Basically... I'm kind of afraid of the Turkish navy, really. Remove Zilesia from the map. Oh! Silesia had actually collapsed to rebels, I didn't notice. So all their conquests were just torn away. And looks like Brandenburg has more or less recovered. So that doesn't change. Good. So, do I want to wait for this? 1700. No, I don't want to remove Silesia from the map. I want something to give me more claims on the Turk. Okay, I think I'm gonna try to... You did what? At war with Tabaristan, Persia, Delhi, and... Yarkand. Just one problem. Delhi and Yarkand probably can't march... to help. Now, suddenly it's far more appealing to start a war with the Turk. Since he is busy in another war. Before that, do we want to threaten war with someone? I mean, we can't really do it because we... our claims are all the way over here. We have a claim on Al-Jari that expires. 1716. It's the only claim we have on you. I think I'm just gonna make claims on these guys until I'm good and ready. Bashkird. Next claim on you would cost 35, so keep going. We're slowly unifying the country religiously. That's a good thing. So yeah, I'm gonna wait for one more claim. It's gonna take us, I don't know, 9 months, maybe? No, less than that. 6 months, maybe. I think that's gonna be good. By that time, the Turkish army should be marching all the way over here, fighting all these guys. I really hope that Delhi and Yarkand can actually reach there. Let's see, Tabaristan and Yarkand, so he won't allow any of them through. Is that the land bridge? A little touchy there. Are these two provinces bordering, or are these two provinces bordering? Who knows? Yemen has started westernizing. Delhi is rival to Sindh. Sindh could grant access. Currently isn't. This is what? The conquest of Karazim. Yeah. Another province is called. Come on. Give me spy efficiency. So I can attack the Turk. While he's away. Oh dear. Armor fodder died. My goodness, no level 3s. In that case, sack the level 1s. You can afford that. I want a level 3. Once. Kasimov. Do I care about you, Kasimov? I mean, at this point, it's just... yeah. Probably don't, really. Oh, I'm just coring you right now, and you're... Sure, take the autonomy. You're actually pretty worthless right now, so... That's fine. Tabaristan is subject to rebels. Not good. For them. Come on, I need 40 points. Just need 40 points. Then we can play ball. And by then, the Turk should be deep in the steppes. Oh, let's see. Lose mercantilism? No. Well, that sucks. So now I cannot do anything to make them happy again. If I'd make that, if I give them influence, they'll pop across, and if I do that... Ah, boo. Okay, we'll have to do this, and you'll have to be unhappy for quite a long while. Yeah, yeah, and France declared war on Württemberg. Oh, bad France. Bad France. More mercantilism, because I want it. And the papal legate stuff expired. Clergy, where are you? Yeah, sure, send an emissary. We need the papal influence. We want to buy that up. And did we get more advisors? We did indeed, and we got some ones we can actually use. So, do we want the guy that gives us more manpower in total, or do we want the guy that drains manpower much faster? Because that's effectively what he'll do during war. He'll drain your manpower pool, so you'll be quicker to recover. But if you're sieging, that'll actually hurt you a bit. No, I think I'm gonna go with this guy. Because that increases the manpower pool total, and it also increases the monthly regain. Yeah, that seems like a better idea for me. To me. And suddenly you decide to switch. Okay, so we still have this in the bag. We have 3 electors, he has 2. Yeah, I need that last diplomatic reputation if I'm supposed to succeed here. Ah, well. Need the Lancets. No, I do not want to conquer more in the Empire. I'm kind of done. Pushing into the Empire when I'm this close to actually becoming Emperor again. Because if I do become Emperor, we are in a much better position to do evil things. Truce will expired. And that is fine. Next month we should have enough influence for this. Yeah, this is bad. I can hope that France gets smacked around a bit, but yeah. They're pretty darn strong. Don't see that happening. Britain has built up a tremendous army. I'm kind of surprised. And they would actually become my friend. Look at this, they are rival to France, the Papal State, and Mali. Rival to. So they're not rival to Spain anymore. Huh, cool. Yeah, okay, so I might have to smack France around once I'm emperor, not before. And I need another claim. So let's go for the richest possible province I border. 10. It's probably not going to be over here. 17, that's pretty rich. Uh, 22, Biga. Yeah, okay, we're going to fabricate on Biga. Recall the one from Ragusa. You might want to do something with Ragusa later, but not right now. Because right now it is war with the Turk time. Just to distract him a little bit. Hello, Turkey. I want quite a lot, actually, but I'm going to settle for Koenig as the war goal. I'm going to call in Spain because I can. And because that'll mess them up a bit. We are going to go like so. Actually, no, you're gonna stay in the area. And that should spark a war here. There we go. Another kill. Greifswald is not interesting. The Spanish Navy is probably far away. I'm just gonna march around. Can't cross there easily, and so that's gonna be interesting to see what the AI does. Instead, that's okay. Hopefully building up trust with the electors. I need them to trust me. Trust me! I'm not doing anything naughty. At all. Not really. Nah. We aren't mean. We aren't evil. Do I border France? I actually do border France. In that case, let's build a spy network on France. Because I might have to declare war on them afterwards. Because they are becoming quite a bit of a nuisance. Pushing deep into the empire, that's not good. I need to evict them if I'm going to be a good emperor. The states are disloyal, very disloyal. But there's not much I can do about that right now. Let's see here. These provinces don't border forts, so I'm just gonna try to grab them. I expect that they'll now begin to immediately return. I would be kind of surprised if they did not. And I think I'm gonna do something rather odd. I'm gonna pull him back. Fabricate another claim up here. Because I can. Can I fabricate on Gilan? I can. Let's do that. Because that might become Ottoman territory. So here's what I'm thinking. It's gonna cost us a diplomatic point, I know, but it might be worth it. You are granting. Oh, I don't need to. Okay. So yeah, you're granting access to the Turk already. So that means he can march through because he should have has conditional. Yeah. So he Delhi can march through Sindh and so can Yarkand. So they can reach their ally. Which is kind of cool. Okay, back to Hess. Let's see if we can convert him into voting for us. Can't be much of a deal. A tiny bit of, yeah, we need more diplomatic reputation, so as soon as that straightens out, things will be fine. Occupied Mosul. This one borders a fort, so we can't quickly occupy it. So now the Turk is in a two-front war. Lovely. Okay, give them what they want. There aren't any forts down there, so let's march around and just cut them off. Yeah, they definitely have started building up more of an army. I did not quite see this coming, I guess. I'm sure they did, but we won a siege already. Lovely. Go there and no, don't go there. Go straight to the fort. And we'll have one of these armies go there, and the other one's gonna go here. Start sieging, taking the war goal. Could kind of help. Maybe we'll do a small kill here. Possibly. There we go. Yeah, he's sieging down this one with quite a stack, but nah. That's Hess. Keep boosting our own electors. It's kind of dangerous not to look at the main screen while at war, and there's why. There is why. So he's marching. No, he stopped. Pretty much all infantry. You're staying right there. Get the good leader aboard. As soon as Sinas is occupied, good. Move. This is dry lands, so it should be feasible. Oh, you have to go through there. You'll arrive 11th of February. And you'll be there on the 8th. Wait 3 days. There we go. Yeah, there will be river crossings and all that fun stuff, but I don't care. Twice the numbers. I do think this should be okay. 424 is the 244. Feel reasonably confident. Well, this is king. Yeah! Stack wipe! Woohoo! Lovely. Lovely, lovely, lovely. Okay, gonna move on. Like so. Now I feel a lot more confident in this war. Oh, maybe we can get some more. Oh no, we're attacking into mountains. No? I don't know. Now he should be in a losing war, I hope. I really truly hope that he'll lose this war. Yeah, just start occupying territory. Lessen his ability to rebuild. Sounds like a decent idea. And I don't want to split the armies up, because the Turkish army is still quite large. So I don't really want to do too much splitting up just yet. I think I'm gonna just occupy this territory. Kind of like cut him up a bit. The Spanish fleet is of course very busy because he's fighting Sofala. And losing spectacularly, as expected. They declare war before they have an army in place, and that's disastrous. I really wish they tweaked the AI declaration of war thing to actually consider, are my armies in place? Are my armies close to his borders? Yeah, border claim with France, that's very nice. I wanted something like that. If I get the crown again, the Imperial crown, he will have a lot of fun with that. A lot of fun, but it's so close. It's so close. To crit, that's down here, and you decided to unseat me, you little bastard. That's not gonna fly. That's not a port. Go to Konya and then back down to the... yeah. Ooh, new tech. Admin tech. No, I'm gonna wait a year until it's cheap. A few quick battles. Good. He's retreating. Good. So the other guys are actually beating him too now. Very good indeed. And we're killing off some of the smaller stacks he's building. Still no mission that actually appeals to me. Oh, here comes Spain. Conversion, yes. Cossack aggression. Demand Cossack justice. And we still lost Spain. Okay. Evil Muscovites, you'll cost me a base tax. I shall be avenged. And you shall be destroyed. You're mostly marching through, but I'm gonna go there, take that province, then we go to the fort. Because it seems like the Turkish AI is prioritizing this war. Which I don't really find objectionable. I do not mind. Yeah, which way do we want to go? Let's go south. Just take more land. And you've accumulated quite a stack up there. It's gonna be interesting to see what you're gonna do with that stack. You're starting to march on me. You're marching in my direction, aren't you? No, that can't be tolerated. Maybe you aren't. Maybe you're just trying to gather up your army strength. I don't know. And therefore, Ankara goes away. Yeah, I can't really do much to secure my election other than try to butter up to these guys. And unfortunately, he switched over to Württemberg. Unfortunately, Württemberg, who is probably gonna die. Which is kinda bad, because then suddenly the Palatinate will put out another elector. Come to think of it, yeah, I might have to do some sneaky business here. We'll see. I suddenly had a plan. Okay, you are marching where? Draka, probably to this one. So let's see if we can go over there. Help. Just when Britain is on. Now the siege is done, good. Occupy this one. Now you're marching on... where? Okay, marching up there. Okay. I'm gonna go up there and see if I can meet you. Yeah, I might have to do something sneaky like... force peace. Can I do that? Enforce peace. Yeah, if I had a diplomat, I could potentially do that, and it's certainly starting to have some appeal. I'm gonna put the siege guy in charge of this army and go for his capital. I need to see if I can get that little stack up there. Tibaristan asks for access. Sure. Come on in. Let's destroy the Turk together. I mean, you should be able to push him back now. I weakened him a fair bit, so... I'd be kind of sad if you couldn't. You decide to stand there. A smaller army. See if we can kill that. Spanish, yeah, the Spaniards are going up to kill that one, so. Five more points, okay, keep going. I'm gonna possibly threaten a war. Plus 35, ouch. You're winning every single battle, aren't you? Oh, it's already over. Hesse will annul all treaties with the Commonwealth. Oh, France, I absolutely freaking hate you right now. Okay, that's it. Before France does anything else. That was the drop. That was the drop, France. You must die. You must die so incredibly much. Okay, so I need Württemberg to like me more. I need you to love me, Württemberg. Send gift. 50 ducats, now you love me. The problem is, of course, I can't really set my troops over there right now. Because I'm kind of busy. The Spaniards killed them, that's to be expected. I got there too late. Boo. Okay. Yeah, just finish that and we'll see if we can what we can do to kill the smaller stacks. The forts are what really matters, so. So France, hello. Enforce peace, Wittenberg. No. Confirm. That should bring me into that war. Very good. So the question is, could I possibly bring you into that? No. Of course not, because it's not really my war. Which means I need to free up some regiments or build some new ones. And I'm gonna do that. Build one new stack. We need to deal with them now. And yeah, you're gonna go up here. This is probably, yeah, it's defensive in the mountains, but I don't care. Go there, kill that, and move all the way around. With the Spain showing up here, and of course them being very distracted, I think this is gonna work out just fine. So you had to kill my biggest chance here, didn't you? Darn you, France. And now I'm pretty certain this is gonna last a long while, so war taxes. Go, save us some money. You are also going to switch back to Europe. It's gonna take a long time, but get marching. Siege Isel, okay, so now I can go kill them. Because the war with France takes precedence right now. Pretty certain that the Turk is dead, so there's not that much more that Turkey can do. I keep saying Turkey. The Ottomans, there's not that much they can do. So I basically have to pile together one heck of an army and visit the French army, which has suddenly ballooned even more. Which is not good. They are definitely going to be a challenge to take out, so. Okay, two of our armies are on the way. And that's not going to be enough. We're going to need even more if we're to actually deal with them. But I kind of need my armies in this theater. This kind of sucks. And you can also start marching. This way, 120,000 Poles. We might have a chance. So he has a fort out there, that's unfortunate. Go there first. Just unsiege, or on the siege those. Oh, we are being under attack. We are under attack, and that's a mountain square, but I cannot get a leader there. Oh, that's gonna hurt. That's gonna hurt. So no leader, but I'm in the mountains and have a significant morale and tactics advantage. I don't have a leader though, and that kind of sucks, and I probably should have taken the Mercury and sent in a leader, but because he has so many troops here. Yeah. Oh dear lord. Lorraine dies. You are going to retreat to Constantinople. They're still at war here. And Spain decided to go siege. Okay, so you switched. priorities on me. That's unfortunate. Yeah, you're gonna march here. I should probably group up the few armies I have left in this theater while I build up the forces that are going to try, at least, to deal with France. Oh, and we've been playing for far too long. Time for a break. Thank you for watching, and I hope you'll continue to do so.